Well, hello there. Here we are on Friday evening at 8:32 p.m. up here in northeastern Ohio on July 12th, 2019. And I just cannot pass this up. We have the pretty blue skies with a bright white moon there, and it just is stunning. And let's look here. The moon is 86% lit and 25 degrees above the horizon right at the moment. I kind of don't want to move with all those birds flying around. I haven't done a setup or anything yet, but I would like to get it the right size, closer to what I see by eye. That's close, but no cigar. An old saying for you young folks. That's just about the size, I think, if the monitor's picking it up properly, but get a little bit of the willow tree in there, blue sky and a white moon. We'll take it, babe. Okay, I have to do a setup now, so. Ow. I'll be right back. Alrighty, there we go. Now, we can't see the features of the moon quite as well than you can at night, but it's a pretty sight with those sweet songs of the bird chirping. He's over in the willow tree. He, she, whatever. Let's go up to max zoom here. Whoa. There we are. Wow, it looks like there's a bit of shading there tonight. And it's not from a photo bombing of the tree. We'll let the birds do the narrating on this one. They're pretty songs. Okay, our light beam area above that mesa and down below to the right of it, what looks like a question mark to me. Last night, I don't know if it'll come out tonight. Let me move over here. Let's see. Yeah, this area, it came out well in the stacked photos. But this is the area that always reminds me of numbers and letters up there. It's difficult to make out, but it was like a 3 and a 2 and an F. And but I'll include that stack in here and you can see better. Well, there's a bright spot. All right, let's finish up here. There we go, that was a pretty good view for daytime. And of course, it's too early for any planets or anything else. That's the only thing in my sky. The sun's blocked in the northwest from houses and trees, so Jupiter rose about 2 hours ago, and Saturn and Pluto have also. But anyway, it's 8:42 p.m. and we'll close this out for now. Alrighty, I hope to be back later. Take care now. Bye. Pretty bird. She's singing up a storm. Alrighty, we waited it out. Brought the Canon 80D out for a few pictures, and there's Jupiter above that tree. Let's try to have this SynScan thing slew over to it. I don't have the best, oh yeah, that wouldn't affect it. Okay. Alright, so let's go up and see how far off we are. Okay, hang on. I'll do a fast forward through the setup and all that stuff. Okay, so there's a band one. Whoops. Okay, there we go. I think that's the best we're going to get it in for this time of night. I can see the bands pretty well. And I'm going to have to do something, so I'll have to be right back. I want to make things easier for me for trying to do the stacking, so I'm going to stop this video, just do a like 15 second, 20 second clip that I can use in that application instead of putting this whole video into Final Cut Pro and cutting pieces out and all that stuff. It takes so much time. So let me do that. I shall be right back. All right. We finally see Saturn rising. Right over there. And those stars around it. So hang on while I try to do this setup for it, and I'll be right back. Alrighty, we got him. So we have the trio again tonight. Whoa. Alrighty, I'm going to be right back. I want to get the 10 to 20 seconds footage. I wish this would stop drifting so much. Alrighty, I'm back. I got all those 15 to 20 second clips, which should help somewhat. As we go to try to stack that software, or stack the footage. Yeah, it was such a pain. I had to take the whole long movie, which could be anywhere from 60 gigs to 100 some gigs of footage, and put it into Final Cut Pro, and then it does its rendering and all that good stuff, and then I try to cut out all the pieces of full-on views, and then take that stuff and put it into the stacking application. Oh my goodness. So hopefully this will work out better. If I didn't screw anything up. Hey, you never know. I will look around for any stars. I don't see any by eye. But I am stuck under all these trees, too. It's funny how well the camera picks it up when I use the long exposure shutter speed. And it shows all those white dots up there. And it sure isn't what we see here. All I see is Jupiter and the moon. That's it. I can faintly see Saturn right now, finally. But if you see any flashing long streaks on here, it'll be lightning bugs, fireflies. They're quite active. Boy, there's a beautiful rainbow ring around the moon. And these cameras just will not pick it up. It's gorgeous. But that should be good enough. Like I said, I'll probably put some photos in here and do that kind of stuff and hopefully have something new. I don't know. Oh, and I probably forgot to say it, but we are on the Nikon P1000 camera for the video and recording onto the Atomos Ninja Flame using the Skywatcher telescope mount to track everything. And the photos were taken with the majority of the photos were taken with a Canon 80D and that Tamron 18 to 400 mil lens. Oh, I wish something would pop up here. There's no stars or galaxies or much of anything out here for me. Actually, I do see Antares. Okay, that faint speck of light, which you probably can't see on here, that's basically what I see by eye. Barely anything. Okay, so we have it aligned on Saturn, and we're going to have this go-to mount take us to Antares. And I don't have a good setup, so it might just give us a general area. We shall see. Alrighty, there he is. He's coming into view. Try to get it in focus. Alrighty, that dancing ball of light up there is Antares. It's down about the 5 o'clock position from Jupiter. So that's basically the best we can get for stars with this type of camera. A shimmering, flashing, colorful light. Alrighty. Well, we got four of them tonight. That's gonna have to do. We pack up all this gear and head on in. Okay, it's 9:57 p.m. So I wish you all a wonderful weekend. Have a safe one. And hunker down for you guys down in the Gulf. Alrighty. Good night now. Bye.